probably already know that every bite you eat makes its way into your stomach where it's digested. But what does that actually mean? What is digestion and how does it work?
Let's find out on today's episode of
Colossal Questions.
The process of digestion doesn't start in your stomach. It actually starts in your mouth, even before you've taken your first bite. You see, saliva doesn't just make it easier for food to slide down your gullet. It also begins breaking down chemicals in the food, starting up the digestion process right there in your mouth. When you finally get a bite and sink your teeth into whatever it is you're eating, the saliva breaks down the food even more, making it easier to mash up and swallow. With the help of your tongue, all that chewed up food makes its way to the back of your throat. Once you swallow, the food leaves your mouth and enters the second section on its digestive journey, the esophagus. The esophagus is the long, stretchy tube behind your windpipe. Think of it a bit like a tunnel. The walls of your esophagus are lined with muscles that squeeze the mushed up food down into your stomach. Inside the stomach is where digestion really kicks into high gear. Lots of us picture our stomach as a big sack, half full of acidic liquid that dissolves away whatever we eat. But that's not quite right. Instead, think of your stomach a little bit like a natural blender full of acid. The walls of your stomach are lined with super strong muscles that ooze out acidic gastric juices that break down the food even more. They stretch and squeeze your stomach, churning up everything inside and breaking the food down into smaller and smaller bits. Once your stomach is done doing its digestive work, what's left of the food is ready to move on to the next stop in its journey, the small intestine. The name is a little bit misleading because your small intestine is anything but small. All stretched out in a line, it's actually over 20 feet long. That's about as long as a string of lights you'd put on a Christmas tree, all coiled together inside your belly. As the food mixture makes its way through 20 plus feet of twisting and turning intestine, digestion continues. As you might imagine, this is the longest part of the process. It can take up to 4 hours for food to make its way through your small intestine. During that time, the pancreas, liver, and gallbladder all produce special juices that help your body process the minerals, proteins, carbohydrates, and fats left in the food mix. Once the mixture is finally done making its way through the small intestine, what's left are just the parts of the mushed up food your body couldn't use. All that stuff goes right into the large intestine. The large intestine is wider than the small intestine, but nowhere near as long. Only about 5 feet if it was laid out in a line. While it moves through, water is absorbed out of the food mix, making the waste less of a mushy mess and more of a harder mass. And then, of course, the digestive journey finally reaches its triumphant conclusion in the bathroom. A gross end to an all-around icky journey through your guts.